was a child just born just after the independence, na? So there was a great spirit at that time of nation building and how one should take it seriously, that India is something worth investing in, that India has a lot of problems, right? There was no running away from the problems of India. But these problems have to be looked at from a point of compassion. And one has to really understand what it means to rebuild the country. After I finished my BTech in IIT, there were only 3-4 of us who did not apply to go abroad. Using a colonized mind to interpret India was a form of himsa. So when you spoke either to Dr. Seshadri or to Dharampal ji, they would point out where our dialogue and discourse was a colonized discourse, right? And decolonizing itself, I think for both of them, was a very important aspect of ahimsa, because it's a very oppressive thing to take on another view and say that every indigenous view of mine is somehow subordinate, right? Or it has to be held in shame. These people understand the word dharma, right? And what they understand as dharma is also layered and very nuanced understanding of the word dharma. How the kudam works is this, na? When you come into the kudam, you drop all attributions to yourself which are based on position, power, property, all of that. You come in as human beings. You engage with a question that is of equal importance to everybody. And every person in the kudam has equal voice. So there is a very, very solid understanding of democracy, where in the kudam, everybody has equal voice because it impacts everybody's life. You have an understanding of larger and larger dharma, right? Larger and larger circles of belonging and your own self. His understanding of this kind of a dharmic sense, he equated with Gandhiji's idea of the oceanic circles, right? Where when I act in dharma, right, and I understand greater and greater circles of inclusiveness, and I bring in the concept of dharma into greater and greater circles of inclusiveness, then my actions will be ahimsa, ahimsatmik. This is the connection between the political process and ahimsa. The question, what is dharma, is simply to ask yourself, right, what will give me life? What action will increase or enhance my life, your life, if I'm dealing with you, and the life of the context simultaneously? I've actually heard stories related to me by this young person sitting in front of me, of how, because he walked through a village road street with his chappals on, he was beaten up. Right? And when through my listening, I touch him at a human level and I understand and empathize and suffer with him, sahridayatva, na? Something happens. And he sees me as a human being. Right? And then the way they relate to you is completely, completely changed. I'm saying this possibility exists in India. Something like, you know, there's a deep shame of some kind that is held inside, and all these caste differences and so on have become proxies through which one claims a certain kind of position or certain kind of power or a certain kind of voice. But the fundamental issue that the Indian voice has been lost is not understood. And so what we're trying to do in Ritambara is just this, to create a set of, you know, people called sacred activists who have a strong anchorage in the Indian idea of psychology, Indian idea of self, Indian processes of dialogue, and then apply it for creating ahimsatmic ways of dealing with issues.